Hello Scrappers, in this video I will show you this board. I bought it as scrap power supply board. It was super cheap, only 50 cents, but basically after I remove the elements that contain palladium and gold, I will be able to sell this board for 50 cents. So basically I'll get my gold and palladium for free. Let's start. The first thing I mentioned on this board are multiple brown Bulgarian capacitors, and some of them are pretty big. They contain a lot of palladium and also silver. Let's cut them first and I'll show you closer look to them. So you see the label and you see what kind of elements you should search for. So this one is marked BE, but can be different. They have BC, BE, different type of marking, and label can vary, but basically the content is pretty high, the palladium content in these brown capacitors. So far I have five. Let's look around for more. So this is number six. This is number six. I see one small here. It's number seven. And of course, at the end you'll measure them and I'll do some estimation of how much palladium I will recover from these capacitors. I see two more here hidden. Let's move this wiring cap. As I said, this was power supply board, and obviously no one mentioned that there are some elements that are super rich of palladium, like these capacitors. So here, if you look here, you see that there are three black capacitors. These ones contain palladium, they are similar to the brown ones. I'll show you closer look to them, so you can see what exactly to search for when you scrap electronics. Okay, in total 12 capacitors, 9 brown and 3 black, but the black ones are really small, so not that much palladium in them. Just the MLCC inside is very small. Okay, what else? I checked their catalogs online and most of these elements are Soviet Union. So I checked them and I saw that this here, this transistor, has almost no gold. It's something like 0.0009 or something like this. So that's why I will just leave it. I don't need this one. But here is electronic circuit that I will try to carefully cut from the board. In general, it's good to use some heat gun or something else to remove them, because there is a diffusion of the gold within the solder and you're losing a little bit gold when you cut them, because part of the legs with some gold are left in the board. But for this video, and to be quicker, I will just cut it like that. So here it is. Look at this nice gold plated legs, and inside it's also gold plated, so you see. Okay, and there are two more transistors that have gold. This is the first one. I'll cut it. Do the same. I'll cut it really close to the board, and there is some plastic, and you can see the bottom is gold plated, and these are the Soviet Union 2T6561, I think. So this is number one, and this one is not easy because it's hidden here, but I should make some space and try to cut it like this from the board. When you use a heat gun, it's easy because you just heat the back of the board and remove the elements one by one. Now my wife is a little bit more difficult cutting them, but that's fine. So here it is. It's exactly the same as the first one and the same mark. So it's 2T6821. Here is better visible. I'll show you a closer look. I'll put a picture so you can see exactly what it is. So what is remaining here? Basically nothing. You have these huge capacitors, they contain aluminum. You have here some metal, probably some brass inside of these connectors. You have, here is copper probably inside. Here, this element, I was about to miss it. So this is a resistor, SP5. You can also check them in the catalogs, and they contain palladium. I'll break this one and show you what I mean. It's inside. So let's break the plastic. When you see elements with such a screw on top, usually these are resistors, pretty old. This one is from 84, 11th month 1984, era of the Soviet Union. So we cut this part, we cut this part, and basically we remove the plastic. Some of these resistors, especially the small ones that contain a lot of palladium, but this one is not that rich because of the label. 2.2 kilo ohms is not that good. Basically palladium contains only this part here, the contact. Let me remove it. I'll show you a closer look of this contact. So this contact is the only part that contains palladium. In some resistors, 100 ohms or less, also this wiring here can contain palladium. So you have to check also this wiring of the resistors if you are not sure what it is. But for this one, only this small, tiny contact contains small amount of palladium. Here it is. Of course, one resistor means nothing, but if you have 1000, maybe you can get 30-40 grams of palladium, which is pretty nice from these resistors. So I'll just stockpile them and keep these small pieces. Okay. What else? Let's remove this trash. These capacitors. I always cut the legs of these capacitors like this, because this is just extra metal that you don't need. And when I recover palladium from such capacitors, I do the calculation based on capacitors without legs. So from these brown ones, you can go above 40 grams per kilogram palladium for sure. But let's consider the minimum. I'll put 40 grams per kilogram and I'll do some calculation based on the weight. Here it is. I'll cut the legs also of the black ones. Legs are not needed at all. This is just extra base metal that you don't need. One more. Here it is. Okay. I'll take my scale, clean up a little, and show you how much gold and palladium I get for free from this board. I cleaned up a little, and let's check how much palladium we have in these capacitors now. I'll measure them. Let's roll the scale. 5.76 grams. If we consider 40 grams palladium per kilogram of these type of capacitors, this means that in this almost 6 grams, we should have at about 0.2, 0.25 grams of palladium. This means, let's say, $12. And this money are coming from nothing, basically. Let's add the black ones. So we are above 6 grams, but these small black capacitors, they are really tiny and MLCC inside is very small. So I don't have high expectations to them. My biggest expectations are to these huge brown capacitors. they contain more palladium than, significantly more palladium than the small ones. This small piece I'll not measure even. It comes as 0.01 probably gram, but you need hundreds and thousands of these contacts to have some result. So just stockpile them. Also this gold part. From the two transistors, I can easily get 0.01 gram of gold, even more. And this IC probably is 0.01 at least. So from these three electronic components, I can probably get at least 0.02 grams of gold, which is at about $1 or more. I don't process them separately. I process them in batches. I collect hundreds and then process them. Otherwise, it's meaningless and not cost effective, considering the acids you need to process this. But let's say it like this. If you know well the elements and the content of precious metals in the elements, you can buy such a board that is considered total crap by someone and grade it as power supply, low grade. You can remove elements for $13 from it. And you can again sell this board back to the same person for the same 50 cents. So that this means free palladium and gold. And the only reason to earn this money is the knowledge. Because you know that these capacitors contain palladium and these elements contain gold. No, knowledge really matters. Thanks for watching, keep scrapping, and don't forget to recover the precious metals at the end. Bye!